Jack Dorsey, former CEO of Twitter and founder and CEO of Square, in a series of tweets last week criticized over the direction of Web3.0 development. Next day, Elon Musk, CEO of Tesla, joined Dorsey in the criticism. But what exactly is Web3.0? It is basically an umbrella term for disparate ideas all pointing in the direction of eliminating the big middleman. The starting days of internet in the 1990s were Web 1.0. The web was seen as a way to provide access to information and mostly contained static pages, contents being served using CGI, and there weren't great ways of navigating. It was pretty disorganized. Starting in the mid-2000s, platforms like Google, Amazon, Facebook emerged to bring order to the internet by making it easy to connect and transact online. Critics say over time those companies amassed too much power. Many consider them as the big middlemen, and Web3 is about grabbing some of the power back. Now, you'll be wrong to equate Web3.0 to Semantic Web, which was conceptualized by Berners-Lee back in 2001. Web3.0 has moved well beyond the original concept of Semantic Web. In Web2.0, as you're browsing social network, posting online pictures and videos, you are a product and consumer. In Web3.0, you are expected to be owner. You'll have full control of your data, not some middleman. Odyssey, for example, is a YouTube alternative where videos can be posted. It runs on open source software that is driven by public developers, not managed by corporate tech giants. While YouTube stores videos uploads into its centralized servers, Odyssey works like a peer-to-peer data exchange distributed over a network in order to avoid centralized servers. This underlying tech is not necessarily new. Cryptocurrencies, for example, like Bitcoin, use the same blockchain technology, a sophisticated version of earlier upload-download peer-to-peer systems like torrents. Another notable feature of Odyssey is the income generation model. While YouTube creators primarily rely upon advertising revenue dependent on the number of views, Odyssey offers multiple options for monetization independent of advertising revenue. Web3.0 in theory is the monetization of compute by individual users. But many don't think it's realistic that Facebook, Google, or any of these will be dethroned by inferior decentralized apps unless they have a disrupting aspect. The problem is that large governments like China and probably even the US and big corporations are going to fight against decentralization because then they would lose the control over the internet that they have been enjoying for so long.